you all for sharing this event. We're looking forward to a great time with this evening. We are going to have some words from one of his very, very dear friends who he loves to his core. And he loves him so much that we can't help but to love him too because of the love he has for you. So I'm gonna bring up Mr. Webb Norman.
Here. No one has ever accused me of being a reef. No. A wonderful honor it is for me to be with you tonight. I'm just telling you that this man has a personality of great influence, not only here in this church, but throughout the community. It is. I've known you virtually the whole 40 years, and we've always had a good time together. And you know, the one mystery that I've never figured out is how did you get Linda to agree to marry me? Now that just goes to show you what the power of personality will do for you. Because I'm your own without Linda, you're
right. You're right.
When I think of Pastor James, I do not think of short words to say. But Aristotle was one of my favorite philosophers. And one day in math classes, a 10-year-old boy asked Aristotle, "How many is one?" And Aristotle said, was sort of surprised at the question. He said, "Let me think on that tonight. And I will give you my answer in the morning." And the morning came, and he said to this young man, "In the affairs of mankind, one can be a very great many." And that describes you beautifully. You're affected, and you do continue to affect the lives of so many by filling their needs and helping them solve their problems. And that's the job description of a great bishop, isn't it? Congratulations to both you and Linda, and thank you for letting me be a part of your life. I do want to say what an exciting present to be with Donnie Wright. I haven't seen Donnie for a long time, and her son and Sarah and our children were wonderful leaders in the practice district. And then Mrs. Deborah. And what a nice thing to see her again. I have many wonderful thoughts and memories about both Lenny Wright and John Deborah. They're great leaders. And to make my short speech short, as I see this room, I almost always see it on Thursday when you are administering to those who need food. If our president could come here on a Thursday and see this congregation doing what they do every week, he would say, he would change his opinion that America is not going to hell. It's a great country, thanks to people.
You are the fire, we are the tempo. You are the voice, we are your song. You are our God, we are your people. You are the light we stand on. into your love, into your light. Grace upon grace, beauty for ashes. You come to us, we come alive.
Continue on with our words of honor and appreciation. We are going to have a small walk down memory lane. Bishop and First Lady, can I get you to come and take a seat here for me, please? And the song went like this. Christian Union Academy, we should always honor you. You prepared us for a great future. In the many things you do, your teaching is excellent, and you go beyond the basics. You strive for the best, and I stand out among the rest. I'm proud to be a part of the academy. Oh, yeah. When we had Christian Union Child Care Academy, the very first in Rockford, Illinois, to have a Black African American school under Bishop James, celebrating 40 years in the ministry. I believe if I looked up Bishop Leonard James, I would find these characteristics to describe him. Humble, compassionate, selflessness, innovative, teacher, and a survivor. Let's take a moment to look at some of his many accomplishments during his 40-year reign here at Christian Union. Selflessness would be pantry, foster care, community projects such as Easter egg extravaganza, fall festival, backpack giveaway, Thanksgiving dinner, nursing home, rescue mission, the meal, jail ministry, set on the board for Red Cross, set on the board for Rockford Park District, and the best of the West. Community leader, he was the first and second presiding bishop of Alpha and Omega, moderator for Rockford and Vicinity Association, advisor for Progressive Baptist District, innovative and not afraid to step out of the box. He was the first to have women preachers, first to have praise dancers, first to have praise teens. We've had steppers, we've also had poets, we've also had hip hop rap, we've also had youth dance, we've also had puppet shows and skits. And there's probably some things that I'm missing. As far as evangelizing, we had a bus ministry, door-to-door evangelizing, all right, under his church leadership. As a pastor, he is a pastor's pastor. He has ordained many ministers, male and female, and he maintains a strong women's ministry, men's ministry, youth, shepherd's care, and music ministry, and an excellent school of education. He is a teacher. He's a pastor's preacher, as I said, and he continues to teach us. We have a monthly training that is facilitated by him on a regular. And he is a survivor. He has survived 3 strokes and cancer surgery. This is our Bishop, Leonard E. James Sr. And these are just some of the many things that he has accomplished in his 40 years. Now, if you would turn your attention to the slide.
I got Papa when I was born because he was there when I came out at my mom. I love that I love that he takes care of me because he puts food on my table and clothes on my back, and he never gave up on me.
I met him when Ashlyn and my dad met, and I was about 5 or 4 years old. That when I come over, he takes care of us, and when I spend the night, he does the same thing, he lets us spend the night, and he's nice, and he's kind.
The first time I met Papa was probably when I was first born. He's very generous, and he cares about me, and he cares about all of us, and he's nice sometimes. The first time I met Puffa was when I was born, and yeah, for sure. And I love Puffa because he's caring. He took us in when we were in need, and he spoiled us a lot. People say he spoils us, and they're right. He does stuff for us that he really doesn't need to, and I appreciate him for that.
The first time I met Bishop was about 25 years ago. I was invited to church by my niece Janina and my nephew Leonard, Elder Leonard. I came to church and I was sitting in the pews in the back there, and Bishop was singing a song, "It's Me." And, you know, not my mother, my brother, but just me. I'm standing in need of prayer. And I knew then, you know, I wanted to meet him, so I met him. And that was the first time that I met him. What I love about him the most is his ability for mentorship. One thing, Bishop, one day, I remember he pulled me in the office one day, and he told me there was a lot of godliness in me, and I just needed somebody to pull it out. And I've been with Bishop ever since then, you know, with his ability, and I'm just grateful for him, you know, for God using him in such a powerful way.
I met Bishop probably about 38 years ago. There are so many things that I love about him, but I will just give you a few. I love the fact that I can honestly say that when he loves hard, and he has a genuine love, and he accepts
for who you are. I can say, there's so many things I could say because he's taken me in as if I was his own ever since I was a little girl, and he's never treated me different, and he's always been there to guide and instruct and to lead me and to love on me and to let me know that I always have his support and I don't ever have to feel as if I'm alone.
20 years ago, you're very a great person, great vision.
I can't remember, it's over 47 years plus. You know, he always treats me the same way as any day. And he's such a people person. And that's why I think he draws people to him. He's a great pastor, a leader. Can't beat him.
Oh, the first time I met Bishop. Oh my God, I met Bishop.
When I met him, I did not have this year. I was a speedy young woman when I met Bishop.
But I would say something like, if I count back, if I was a speedy young woman at the time, I think something like 52 years ago. He's a good educator. He's a, oh my God, a hammer. The reason I say that because still, years ago, when I was a young lady, I'm a young woman, I mean, oh, he used to come to my rescue in the wintertime because I was driving. I couldn't drive on ice. I would park my car when it started snowing. I would call him and he would come to my rescue. I'm sure I'm not the only one he come to rescue, but he's a good helper.
Well, that's been quite some time ago, but now when I met Bishop, he was still an idealistic man. He was a good man because he started so much here in the city of Rockford. Started the daycare center, and we used to go, people say, thought that, well, you trying to be like Jehovah's Witness? No, we was going out in the streets and talking to people. We could get so many people to come to church. We had a big, well, I say, he does so much here in the city, not only for the Christian Union, but the people around in the community. And he's still doing good work. And he's a very, very good teacher. And if you would be with him, you would know him from now on, because everybody liked the bishop. That's what they call him, the bishop.
Well, I met Bishop when we were on School Street, when he first came here, and I don't remember the year, but it's been a while. I think he's a good man. He's been a praying pastor. He's concerned about the church, and I love that about him. He's made a lot of sacrifices, and I just know that God got a greater reward for him, even though it'll have to probably have to come when he gets with God. But I thank God for Bishop and for this church.
I met Bishop several years ago when we were on School Street. And Bishop is a great man. He's a great teacher. I used to love when he taught Sunday school because he would draw you in by the words that he would say, by the conviction that he had on his heart. He just draw you in with the power of teaching. And I love that about him, his spirit of loving God and loving people. And of course, I was his first armor bearer. People don't realize that, but as a nurse of the church, I've supported Bishop. I've done for him, and I would pray for him when he's done preaching and everything. So I think I was his first armor bearer, even though now he has men armor bearers, but I'm still there for him. And I love my bishop, and I also love my first lady.
Well, I met Bishop about 25, 30 years ago. He's one of the better pastors that I've talked to.
I first met Bishop over 25 years ago at this location, Christian Union Full Gospel Baptist Church. I love about Bishop, when I first came here, I started out as an usher, between maturity and up under his leadership, I am now became a minister, now an elder, and help run the pantry and up under his leadership, and he's a great leader. And
so deserve. You guys, I love you. I miss you. I wish I was able to be there. I want to say thank you for the impact you've made in my life. You guys took me in at a time that my family needed it, and you took care of me, and you took care of me with great and with love, and you taught me so many things about the Word of God. You taught me so many things about family living and about relationship, and I just thank you. I couldn't become the woman that I am today without the influence you guys had on my life. I love you, I thank you, and I'm just so honored to be in your life, and I'm so honored that you are, I'm just so honored to know you and to love you guys and to have experienced you guys in just such a loving way. Thank you, congratulations. Yay!
Love you,
Miss
Tess. Okay, bye. And at this time, if you are a member of Christian Union or you claim Christian Union, could you please stand to your feet? Bishop and First Lady, we the Christian Union Church family, we love you. And we honor you today, and we appreciate you for everything that you do. We do not take it for granted, and we pray that God will bless you to have many more anniversaries. And at this time, we will have our invocation by Elder Darrell Stevens, and we will repeat.
We do glory in thee this day, O God.